and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. We've got let's get a few of these out of the way. I've got all sorts of bottles all over the place, I really have. It's bad, isn't it? Right, we've got a kind of interesting one for me, I think. This is, I'll show you the bottle first. This is a White Shield. Now, it's throughout the years, it's been quite highly praised. And I'll tell you why it's an interesting one for me. This is, look at the date on that. See, that is about really when you want to kind of be drinking it. You want to kind of age this one a little bit. So really I'm drinking it a bit green, a bit fresh, a bit newly picked and everything. That's about it, yep. Oh, and the little thing around the top here, look, have a look. Getting it? You got it? Good, good. Now, won awards and stuff. It's been highly praised throughout the years. And it's kind of been looked after now by Molson Coors. Which kind of I'm not highly kind of impressed with for most of their beers, but let's give it a go because I've never actually tried it. Brewed on Burton on the Trent, kind of, so it's not going to need, I don't think anyway, it's not going to need to be Burtonized and anything else. Many breweries around that area, or there was, I don't know if there still is, but we're going to give it a little go. Let's clean my glass up. As I said, it's going to be a little bit, not unfair to drink it this young, but I'm going to have to kind of work my head around how fresh it is and that, and how it should really be aged a little while. So, bottle conditioned. Nice cap. I like that, nice crown. Established 1744, well, it's kind of closed, reopened, and God knows what else. Changed hands a few times, but it's all cool. Good, good. Let's give it a go. Give it an honest opinion. Here we go. Cool, what's that on the glass there? She's been doing the gardening with me glasses again. You know what she does, I'm wiping it on my t-shirt, it's good, isn't it? Right. God, dear. Right, let's pour that. Yeah, as I say, God, that comes rushing out. We've got a long, thin neck on this one. So, it kind of rushed out there like one of your yard of owls. Long thin neck. Oh, it smells nice, it happens. It smells very nice. Right, there's the colours. Let's see what I'm getting first. Right, let's see if I can replicate that for you. You're getting about the same there. There you go. Something like that. There, that's it, dead on. You're getting it there. There's your carbonation. Not too bad carbonation. Kind of looks almost kind of forced, but it's cool. Let's have a sniff. It doesn't smell very special, but let's give it a go. Right, let's have a taste. I'm not getting a lot on those. I'm getting a little hint of toffee. I'm getting like a kind of hint of a citrus in there of some sort. And a kind of piney, a kind of pine sort of smell. Almost like the pine smell you get of the, when you're cleaning the floor, that sort of thing. Alright, let's dive in. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice, that is. IPA, bottle conditioned. Yeah, it says on here, like, fine cask beer, bottle condition, white as well, blah, 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 will mature for at least 3 years. So I could imagine that. You kind of got a Fuggles bitterness there. That, actually, it's quite nice as it is, you know. But I imagine that Fuggles bitterness just getting buttered over, you know, kind of just, kind of smoothed. And there's a kind of there's a north down there as well. Kind of a, like a drying that you get it around the sides here, east bit of the tongue. You get the Fuggles, he's always down the back sweeping up with a big broom. North down comes in and kind of hoovers up, you know, like that. But he also sweeps a bit as well. He's also got kind of. That might be where there's a kind of piney pepperiness in there. Hmm. Hmm. Not sure, there is something else there as well. There's a bit of Maris Otter, I believe. There may be a bit of caramel as well, I would imagine. Caramel, I'm nearly sick. Yeah, maybe a little bit of that. Mmm. It's quite nicely balanced already. But I can imagine those flavours really smoothing. With a little bit of age. What ABV are we? 5.6? Well, now, you know, that's... That's quite something to age something 5.6. That's, you know. Usually expect a bit kind of either highly hopped. It doesn't taste really highly hopped. It may well be, I don't know. Let's see if we've got any yeast to go in here. I often find these ones, these beers... They kind of profess to be yeasty and everything. Look at the head I've poured on the head. Of course, that'll keep some people at me. Wee! I poured a head on something. Look at it! Yeah. I often find these ones that profess to kind of be bottle conditioned and everything else. That's cool. It's brilliant, but I can't really see. Oh, there is yeast in there. Yeah, a little tiny, tiny bit. Enough to do its job. So that is pretty cool because I've just rushed that in there and it's still crystal. It's well carbonated and it's bottle conditioned and there ain't big chunks of peas and carrots in there. I don't know if you can see. Can you just see in there? Wait a minute. Can I get the light there? Maybe not. I don't know. But what about shining the light behind it? You're going to get this. You getting it that now? Just a bit yeasty and not too serious and everything, you know. Which is cool. Which is cool. Yeah, do you know what? it pains me to say it. It does. It's a good one. It is a good one. And I'm going to buy another few of these because at the moment Tesco's have got them £4 for £5. Whoa! And that's very cheap. So, I would say buy it and try it. White Shield. Definitely buy it and try it. And if you're patient enough, stick one or two in a little box somewhere out of the way. You know, if you ever get any of these boxes delivered, Owls by Mail and whatever else, you know, with the little 12 volt things in it, square holes. Pardon me. Stick your kind of bits and pieces. I've got Fuller's, I've got like a Fuller's, what's it called? The one that you're supposed to mature, I can't remember the box one. What was it? I've got a box down here somewhere. Vintage, that's it, Vintage. I've got that. Now I'm going to add one of these. I've got something else, I can't remember what in there. I think I've got one of the Harvey's ones as well. So, I want, if anyone's got one, I want a Thomas Hardy. O'Hanlon's. I want one. I'll swap you something. Right, let's scoff that down, because that's very nice. That is very nice. And I imagine that aging very well as well. So, chin chin, bottoms up, Mastrovia. Cheers. Nice!